What's up, guys? Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be talking about these $19 fake AirPods I got off Amazon. They're not called AirPods, but I'm going to call them fake AirPods for the sake of this video. They look really similar. It's hard to tell apart. They both open the same. They both look the same. All the same. So in this video, I'm going to give you the pros and cons of these AirPods. I'm going to be telling you the specs, and I'm going to be comparing them a little bit to the regular AirPods. If you are interested in possibly getting these, I think I've said AirPods way too many times, but if you're interested in purchasing these after the end of this video, the link is down in the description. Purchase it. If you like it, you like it. If you don't, you don't. Return it. You get your $19 back. So with saying that, let's get into the video. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over the specs of these fake AirPods. Pretty much the specs, what they give you on Amazon to try to get you to buy these, and then I'm gonna give you my experience if those specs are true, fake, not really fake, but maybe exaggerated. And then I'm gonna give you my pros and cons, mainly my cons, because going over the specs and telling you my experience with the specs, it's pretty much gonna give you what you need to know to purchase these. So the first thing you need to know is these AirPods have Bluetooth 5.0. I should say fake AirPods. They're not real. These are not real ones. They're only $19 off Amazon. But it has Bluetooth 5.0. And my experience with it is it did connect very easily when I got it, charged them, put them in my ear. It said pairing in pairing mode. Yeah, that's what it said. Been using them for 2 weeks. I almost forgot what it said. It says pairing mode. After that, I went to my Bluetooth settings, hit T16, and then it said paired, and then it was good to go. Both sides do work flawlessly. I had no problems getting both sides to hook up and work. Very good, and then it was just nice. And then whenever I was done using it for the first time, I put them in, closed the lid. I don't think the lid really does anything but closes and opens, but when I put them in, it was disconnected and my phone was back to regular mode, you know, to using the speakers off of the phone. So that is good. I don't know if Bluetooth 5.0 has anything to do with it, but the Bluetooth, it is easy to connect and it does stay connected. I had no problems with it staying connected. And the latency is no problems. I did play PUBG with these and I had no problems hearing what I had to hear when I had to hear it. Bluetooth connectivity is good on these, very solid. I would say they're about the same as the regular AirPods, in my opinion. But with that, these are a lot cooler. They show you the battery. You will not know the battery life with these on my Apple phone. Maybe an Android phone, but with my Apple phone, you don't know the battery unless this tells you the battery, which it does tell you when you get low. Speaking of battery, let's go ahead and go into the battery department. It says it lasts 20 hours. This actually only lasts about a good, I don't know, I never really listened for, I mean, it lasts me a few days, about 2 days, when the AirPods, my use, will last me about 3. One cool thing about it, which is pretty awesome in my opinion, is each one of these, playback, it will last about 4.5 hours each charge. They do have a little blue light on the side of it. I don't know, that just means it's pairing or paired. That has nothing to do with the battery, but since it was lighting up in my face, I figured I would tell you. But each charge, after you put it in the box, it lasts about 4.5 hours, which is good. It's about the same as the regular AirPods when it comes to the battery life. And also, these charge just like AirPods. So you put them in, you're listening to it, you're good to go. They're connected, listening to music, watching a movie, whatever you may be doing. When you put in there, they say low battery, you put them in your AirPod case and then they're charging. And not only are they charging, but they disconnect from your phone and you're good to go. Throw them in your pocket and you're good to go. The next thing I want to talk about with these is the size. Size is very important whenever you're trying to buy something that is the same as the AirPods, because a lot of people buy these AirPods because how small they are, they throw right in your pocket and you're good to go. So with saying that, as you could see, they are very similar, very small. They're both very small. They both are firm. They both look good. If you wasn't a tech head like people watching this, probably, I don't know if you're a tech head, But if you're watching a tech video, you most likely are. That has nothing to do with this. Excuse that. But anyways, you wouldn't know this from this if, unless you were looking at it super close. They both look almost exactly the same in the front, except one has a light, one doesn't. This one charges with micro USB-C instead of a lightning, which kind of sucks. It'd be cool if it did USB-C, but it does micro USB. I think I said USB-C earlier. I meant micro USB. So it don't do USB-C, which would be cool. But yeah, they're very similar in size. They, you know, can't even hardly tell the difference unless you're a tech head like us. So yeah, I was saying that the next thing I wanted to talk about is has built-in microphones. Each fake AirPod has a microphone built in. So if you have this one in this ear, it has a microphone so you could talk on the phone. This one in this ear, it has a microphone so you could talk on the phone. One of the things that you guys are going to be curious about, do they sound good, you know, from the other person listening to you? Yes. I know a lot of times whenever you buy these things off Amazon, it'd be like the best experience, but then when you call somebody, they can't understand you because it'd be muffly. These actually sound really good. Crispy, clean. I think they're very similar to the AirPods. They're crisp. These are crisp, and so are these. So yeah, the microphone on both sides built in. Very good microphones, nothing to worry about. You can receive calls. You can answer the calls. I might as well jump into that section. You can answer calls as well. Each one of these has a touch-sensitive pad at the top. And what you could do is you could answer a call. You can hang up a call. You can pause a video, start a video. You can pause a song, start a song. But you can't, that's all you can do is answer, hang up, pause, and start. With each one of these, each one has the same, it does the same. So that's cool. It does work great, as you see in this B-roll. Very instant, very easy to use, not hard at all. And the next thing with these AirPods is actually the final thing about them, is the sound quality. It says on here, superior sound quality. It's not superior sound quality. It's fake AirPod quality. The AirPods do sound a little better, not much. They're very close, very, very, very close. I wouldn't go out and spend an extra $130 on these for the sound quality because they sound so close, you barely could tell. If you want to get the Apple ones, I would get them because they're Apple, not because of the sound quality. These sound great as well. Yeah, so what I'm going to go ahead and tell you is my con. The one thing I don't like about these is the lid. The lid is flimsy. Yeah, you might be thinking, dude, that's a dumb thing to knock on it. But if the lid is not, like, it's just, it feels cheap. Everything feels good about it. Like, it's heavy, feels good, everything's great. But this lid is the only thing that feels cheap compared to the AirPods. The AirPods, they feel great. Honestly, they feel really good. The lid is like hardcore, no problems. I've had these AirPods, I think, for honestly over a year now, and the lid is still just rock solid. Had these for 2 weeks. They're honestly still rock solid too, but it's only been 2 weeks, and they just feel like they're gonna break quicker. I don't know if they will. I mean, but it feels that way. But yeah, other than the lid, which honestly don't do anything at all, these things are awesome. They hold their own to the AirPod, the regular AirPods. They do a dang good job. And yeah, they're just great. Would I recommend buying these for $20? Heck yes. I would go down in the link right now and buy it if I was you guys, because these things are really good. It's just the lid. And the lid might last you freaking a long time. For $20, these things are amazing. They're really good. So anyways, that's enough of that. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was fun to make. I know I haven't made one in over, been about 2 weeks now, a week and 5 days, 2 weeks. But yeah, something happened. Something bad happened to my daughter. She is fine though. She was in the hospital for 3 days and we were dealing with that. But she made it out. She is alive. Thank you, Jesus. And I probably will be making a video on that. If I don't, I don't, but I might be. But that's why I had a little break. So yeah, with saying that, make sure you hit the like button, the subscribe button, the bell notification if you're interested in more of these videos. I actually have the same video coming out, but for the fake AirPod Pros. I do have AirPod Pros I'm gonna compare them to, so stick around for that video. I also have a DJI Mavic Pro video coming out, which I'm still making. Stick around, make sure you hit all the notification, all the buttons you're supposed to hit. And with saying that, have a good day.